What are your best memories from childhood? For me, it's school days. I remember running through all the school spaces. While I was in primary school, I had a friend, Sumit, who lost one leg in an accident and was using a wheelchair. I could see the challenges he faced while accessing the classroom and other spaces. He would not participate in any of the sports activities and was often alone. I always wondered what could be done so that he could also enjoy participating with everyone else. Over 6 million children in India do not attend school, and among them, children with disabilities are disproportionately represented. School's built environment is one important aspect that influences access to education, as it can enable or restrict the participation of children with disabilities. Studies highlight that lack of understanding about disability by designers can lead them to create a disabling school environment that impacts the participation of children with disabilities. To explore it further, in my PhD, I used a qualitative approach and interviewed Indian designers to explore how do they understand physical disability and disability-related design needs, and how such understanding is translated into their community school design in Mumbai's informal settlement. The study identified Indian designers' knowledge, attitude, and practice related to inclusive design and with implication to children's participation at school. As an architect myself, I used to think that building a ramp, modifying a washroom, and providing a lift is what accessibility is all about. However, there is much more to that. More than the physically accessible space, school spaces design, for instance, the color, the sitting arrangement, the interior environment, the interactive spaces, the whole science behind child-friendly environment can promote inclusion of children with disabilities. And this could also enable the designers to relook at the school spaces through the eyes of a child. The study findings highlight that involving children in the design process could yield positive outcome for their inclusion, as this would enable them to have a sense of value and belonging with the school spaces. This will also enable the designers to understand their psychology and work on the design. Access to education is a human rights issue, as education empowers an individual to take informed decision. Understanding inclusive school design and designers' experience in creating such spaces can inform change in architectural policy and practice and the design of community schools to be more inclusive towards children with disabilities. And this would enable many more students, like my friend Sumit, to enjoy learning and complete schooling. Let us try and provide a conducive learning environment to these children. And trust me, that is possible by exploring what goes inside a designer's mind. Thank you.